Now we're going to move on to multivariable functions. So you're familiar with our normal standard function, f of x equals whatever. So you can imagine a function as being like a machine. You put in one value, it will do something, and then it spits out something else. Well, with multivariables, let's just look at a case where you've got two variables. With multivariables, you put in two values, let's say 1 and a 3. So what that means is you put in 1, so 1 across in the x direction, and then 1, 2, 3. Let's just imagine you put in a 1 and a 3, and then it will do something. Let's just imagine it spits out the number 7. So you put in a 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. You put in 1, 3, and then it will jump to, let's say, 7 up here. Let's say 7, so it has a height of 7. So here, up here, you put in a 1, and then it will jump to here. You put in a 2, it will jump to here. You put in a 3, it will jump to here. Eventually, it will trace out a line. Well, with two variables, it will trace out. It will trace out a surface. So up here, you've got a line. You've got a line. With two variables, it will eventually trace out a surface, because you could put in, let's say, a 4 here and a 0 here. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, well, in the y direction, there is 0. And then it spits out whatever. So it will jump to whatever is on this surface. So this thing here traces out a line. This thing here traces out a surface. It will trace out a surface. And here, the domain. Remember, the domain is what you can put into the machine without it breaking down. Here, the domain is just the x-axis. It's just, you can put in anything on the x-axis. Here, the domain becomes the plane, the xy plane, It becomes the whole plane. So what it spits out will trace out a surface. But the domain turns out to be the xy plane. Okay, so let's jump to another dimension. So here with three variables. So here, the domain is really your whole 3D volume. Up here, the domain is really the xy plane. Down here, the domain is really the whole of the 3D volume. So your domain is this. So for example, you can put in let's say 1, 2, 3. So you move 1 across in the x direction, you move 1, 2 in the y direction, and then you move 3 up, 1, 2, 3 up in the z direction. So you put in this particular point here, which is 1, 2, 3, and then it would do something, and then it would spit out a value here. So it spits out, let's say it spits out negative 1, so we jump to here. So this thing here, well, up here, the domain is really the xy plane. Down here, the domain is really the 3D volume in the xyz plane. But up here, we have the luxury of using the z-axis, the z-axis to represent our output. Here, we've run out of axis, so we've got to imagine the w as being like a new line here, if you like, and then it will jump to whatever value it may be, because we've run out of axis to represent this w. So let's just imagine this line here to represent our output. So the domain here is really the 3D volume. That is your domain. Up here, the domain is really the 2D XY plane. And then the output, we trace out a surface. Down here, the domain is really your 3D volume, if you like. And then it will spit out whatever value this will be. So we can imagine it in your mind as being like a line. It would spit out, or it would jump to the appropriate value. So let me just give you some examples. Jump to Google and type this in, and then it will show you this surface, and this is your function with two variables x, y, and then punches in, and it will give you this surface. So this is your x-axis here. The origin is actually right here. The origin is right here. So as another example, jump to Google and type in this. And it will give you this weird looking surface. And then if you want to send someone a rose, you can just punch this in and send it to them. Okay? Play around, type in different functions.